I really believe in the teams of Our Lady. My parents belonged to a team for some 50 years of their married life. My father was something of a pioneer in the teams. He was the first non-Catholic to be allowed to join. My parents derived some of their deepest and most enduring friendships from the teams of Our Lady. They chose my godfather from their first team. And when my father chose to become a Catholic, he chose his sponsor from that same first Équipe de Notre Dame as well. The teams of Our Lady gave my parents two building blocks for marriage. The first was communication, and the second was prayer as a family. My mum was a social worker, my dad was a school teacher, so they used to get back from work about 5:30, 6 o'clock, and they would sit down in the kitchen, and I can still hear them as I was working at my homework upstairs, their voices coming up through the floorboards, so to speak, sharing together everything they'd experienced that day. And that day will have begun with all of us gathering, me and my four brothers in our school uniforms with mum and dad, at the foot of the stairs to pray for the coming day. My parents' teams still meet, even though my parents died some 14, 15 years ago, and I was very touched to meet their chaplain recently, who told me, "We pray for your mum and dad at every meeting that we have, and also one of us brings along to the meeting the very same cakes that they used to bring along to that meeting themselves." My parents taught me that the key to an enduring marriage is forgiveness, that marriage is a vocation to forgive, and also to treat and nurture your spouse as your very best of friends. That was brought home to me when, towards the end of their lives, when my parents were anticipating their golden wedding, we were due to have a party, but in fact, my mother was having to spend more and more time in hospital, and my dad was visiting her every day for 1 hour a day. Well, they actually found themselves on their golden wedding day with mum still in hospital. So dad's gift to her was to go and spend the whole day with her. He spent 8 hours with her. And I said to mum afterwards when she was on her own, "Mum, wasn't it a bit sad to be just the two of you in hospital on your golden wedding day?" And she looked at me with love and said, "Well, you know, all we would have wanted was to be together, and we were. And I really gave deep thanks to God for that." How much they loved being together, how much they were the best of friends, was brought home to me when, right near the end of their lives, I would go every Christmas Eve to be with them to listen to carols from Kings. And there was one moment, they didn't realise I noticed, but there was one moment during one hymn when they would always join hands. It was when the choir sang "Once in Royal David's City," and it was as that line approached, "And our eyes at last shall see him." And they would always join hands. "And our eyes at last shall see him." And they would always join hands. They had no idea that I noticed, but I looked out for it every year. And it brought home to me just how much it meant to them to be together. And also their profound hope and expectation and faith that marriage doesn't just end with death, but in fact endures up to eternity.